Hello guys, and once again I am back with a new video, and today I have a very special video for you guys, because this is a mod and it is really cool. Because like any other mod, this mod also has all kinds of new items and stuff, so not only the mod itself is going to be fun, but just exploring what all the things are going to do will be fun in itself. Like, do you see this sword, bow, and this pickaxe that we just got out of our inventory? That is mad. Like, how that can be in Minecraft. But let's just continue taking all kinds of eggs, because we are going to see what they do in a minute, I guess. But did you know that only two mammals can give eggs? Well, give eggs, I don't know if it works like that, but they lay eggs. And those two mammals are the platypus and some kind of weird animal which is the echidna, which is basically just a misshapen hedgehog or something. But it still looks pretty darn cute, so it deserves some respect. But anyways, let's fly somewhere where we can put these eggs to use and see what they are going to do, because I am pretty curious about what all of these eggs have in them. I mean, we can read the names, but there is so much more than a name. But I think here should be good. I mean, why not? It is flat and there is a lot of open space. Whoa, hey, what is this then? This thing is just flying at me. You better not, mate, because I am going to knock you down with my diamond longsword. Well, let's spawn this entity skull name egg, which does not work, so let's continue with another egg then. I don't think this one is going to work either, but it is called entity golem name, so it is going to be a golem, I guess. Well, it seems like we threw the eggs because you can't lay them down next to you, because these things are way too big to spawn near you. Well, and how have I been mistaken by the name golem? These things are freaking awesome though. They just throw dirt at you and they are huge and cool. But it is kind of unfair that I have all kinds of cool weapons that are pretty much overpowered, because I just took two giants out with a longsword and a scythe, and they did not even stand a chance, even though they should have crushed me to death. But let's continue throwing eggs. The corp is next, and oh my god, what is this then? It is some kind of malformed Pokemon or something. It is like Squidward. It is standing up, while I am pretty sure that this animal is not made to stand up, but it might just be because it is probably a water Pokemon, and it is now standing on territory that it is not yet used to, so he can be defeated very easily, and it is just not fair for our corp. But I guess the thing is pretty cool. It is kind of a weird looking mob, but I guess it is pretty cool. But it is pretty mean. It is just flashing its entire body to us, and it has a strong tactic to defeat enemies, which is basically just throwing in its weight at us. Let's eat a golden apple because I do not want to die, and this helps me from not dying. Oh, no, what is it doing? It disappeared? Oh well then, it was not that cool anyways. Let's continue throwing eggs. Let's throw this Malter name egg. Let's see, and oh my god, it is a freaking scared slime that lives underwater, and it looks insane, dude. Have you seen those eyes? It looks so cute but so mean at the same time. And if you come to his territory, then he will just throw you out. What a mighty animal this is. Crikey mate, we can't get any closer to this mighty croc. But we are not quitters, are we? No. My mama did not raise no quitter. We need to keep fighting, just like Bruce Lee or any other fighter that is determined to win a fight. Oh crikey, where did the mighty croc go to? We don't know anymore. Well, that sucks. Oh, but wait, it is right here. It has dug itself more in the water, so it has more chance to win this fight. And I'm not really sure there is any chance that we can even win this fight from this mighty croc, because it is just way too deep for us to fight it, and we are not no submarine, even though my first name is Sub. I am not a submarine. But let's keep fighting it, because it might just feel threatened enough, and then it might be aggressive and it will find us back, and it will not hide under the deep waters anymore, but it might just get to shore in an attempt to slay us, so it can eat and get more cute. But I think it is time to give up, guys. The mighty croc has won this fight, but don't forget that we already won 3 fights, and we are also going to win from this egg that was named Heavy Corp. Let's throw that onto land though, because I think that this is a land animal. Just because of the color of the egg, you can tell if it is a water animal or a land, or it might even be an air animal. But oh my, this is already better than that little puny corp. It does way too much damage to fight this with our bare hands. Look at the size of this thing, man. This is just not normal. And all of this for some fame. Man, I don't know anymore. But maybe these animals are just more scared of us than we are scared of them, because we are the mighty human that can talk and that can build very well, and these animals aren't able to do all of those things, and they are basically just dumb things that roam around. and we have control over our minds. And wait, what did we just spawn? Is this a fudging robot or what? Well, it seems like this was a mistake to spawn this thing, because this thing is going to destroy the entirety of mankind and we are not safe anymore, guys. So let's immediately evict the situation. Don't go home, guys. Let's go to Australia, where it is safe, and that is the land of Steve Irwin. So we are safe there with the spirit of the great Steve Irwin. He will keep us safe from all these creatures, because I don't think it is very normal that a robot just appears here, and I don't really feel safe anymore. But the robot came over to us and we have direct access to his knees, so let's pretend that we are Bruce Lee and we can punch really fast. And the robot is dead? Or is it still alive? I don't know anymore, guys. No, it is definitely alive. Run, we need to evacuate to Australia. Steve Irwin, if you hear this, keep us safe, man. Guys, there is still time. Go to the nearest airport that has a direct flight to Australia. Go there and be safe, my friends. I shall sacrifice myself for the greater good. It has been fun, guys, but now the time has finally come. I think this was a message from God that all the machines in the world are going to take over. Keep eyes on your toaster, because next time that you are going to want to throw some bread in there, who knows what your toaster is going to do. I don't feel safe anymore. There are so many robots all over the world, and now my coffee machine is going to be evil towards me, while it normally should help me get up in the morning. But now it gets me up in the morning just to run away from it, because it might just want to kill me. But this might be a good moment to start about the story that all is going to start in the year 2020. And that is basically code name for the year 2020. And there is going to be a robot revolution, and everyone will have to gang up to defeat their former house. Because just like my toaster and my coffee machine, my washing machine is going to be a great enemy to me. And it will try to wash my face clean off. And like that, we cannot do a face reveal, man. But anyways, in that year there was one robot that started this revolution. And that robot, his name was also Steve, just like Steve Irwin. And his maker gave him that name because he originally was made to defeat some crikey mighty Croc's mate. But that did not happen, because he was too mighty for his maker. He was a great robot, not a small one. And the professor had installed a small piece of technology in the robot's arm, and when the robot that is named Steve would walk next to, let's say, a television, the television would get up and suddenly be a walking robot, and it would not service your needs to watch television anymore, but now it would just attack you out of pure anger. And that robot that is named Steve was built in Melbourne, which is a pretty large city in Australia. And that robot was walking through the city, and to compare the robot to something that was on the street, well, it was almost two times a city light that stands on the side of the road in Melbourne, and those lights were pretty darn big. And now there was a robot that wanted to destroy humanity that was walking through the street, summoning all the electronics in the area, and it was going to walk through the entirety of Australia. But of course, the Australian army would need to stop that, and they needed to come up with a plan that was going to destroy the robot. But like that robot that we previously fought, this robot did not have any weak spots. Well, not that we know of yet. So, we went to the professor, and the professor told us that there was an off button on his back between his buttocks and his spine, and we needed to lift something there, and the button would be exposed and it could be pressed by throwing something at it, or just by pushing it. But all of the lights were off in the city and we could not even see the robot his back. And because of the technology that was used in light bulbs, when the robot named Steve would walk near the light bulbs that were installed in the ceiling, they would just get out and those light bulbs would fight something that was a threat to them. And you might say, well, sub, they are just light bulbs. But that is the thing. They were out of the ceiling, so they would not suffice us from light, and they would also not shine when they are walking, because they did not have a power outlet. But they were driven by the strength of Steve, his arm, that small piece of technology that the professor thought was going to change the world. Well, it did, professor, because you are on a path to be the blame of the end of humanity. But it was late and it was almost 10 o'clock, and when it is 10 o'clock the lights go out. But humanity survived that night because they just hid in Amish communities or barns. And those people don't have technology, so it is a shame, because they also cannot watch my videos because they do not have computers. But well, they did something for humanity, which is keeping it alive one night at a time. But it was 7 o'clock in the morning and the sun was already shining. It was not warm, but the sun was shining, so it was day again and the humans could see. Of course, some of the robots were equipped with night vision, because, well, it makes the story way cooler than if they did not have night vision. Because night vision is freaking amazing, because you can just see at night and everything is green and it is just so cool. But humanity took a break that lasted just like 35 seconds and they could just rest for a bit because it was not easy to be running all the time from the robots. Because I might not have told you, but the evacuation was happening. People in Melbourne already needed to run to the north of Australia, and the cities and villages near Melbourne were threatened to be taken out by technology as well. But those people needed to run, and the people that did have a car or a scooter or any transportation way were lucky. If you had a van, then you could take your important stuff from your house and go on the road and board a plane and go to somewhere safe, because I might have told you that if you go to Australia, you are going to be blessed by the spirit of Steve Irwin. But I don't think you guys understand that this robot was actually Steve Irwin. So, if you are threatened and you are blessed by Steve Irwin, but your biggest enemy at the moment is Steve Irwin, well, what should I tell you, mate? You need to run, boy. But the Grim Reaper needed to come on all kinds of occasions in Australia, because some of the people got taken out by their toaster, some might have been knocked out by their light bulbs that ganged up on them, which is a pretty sad way to die, and some just were chilling and then all of a sudden there was a ring of the entire technology that was in the house around them. And those people, trust me, did not have a chance to fight back, because the technology was so hardly driven by the robot named Steve that those pieces of technology would not give up until they were not driven by Steve anymore. And there was only one way that would happen, and that is with the button that was near his buttocks. And if all of the technology ganging up on humanity was not enough, there were also some weird looking bugs that were just basically bed bugs, but then in a very large version, and they could grow to be at least the same height as a grown man. And if those things bite you, well, you're not in for a surprise, because like it looks like it is going to hurt like. And those things bite pretty hard, just like Steve Irwin. We just died from an animal, but Steve died from a Steingray, and we just died because of a large bed bug that somehow got big and was a threat to humanity as well as the robots were. So, the humans were in a bit of a pickle, mate. And that was not good for them, because no one likes to be in a pickle. Do you guys know that guy that stole the Declaration of Independence in that one movie? Well, that guy is called Nicolas Cage, but now that he was in a pickle, that was not his name anymore. But he was now called Nicolas Cage. And trust me that he did not like to have that name just because his name was Nicholas and it kind of rhymed with pickles, so now he is called Nicolas Cage. And now that one guy from SpongeBob that is called Patrick, which is a sea star, did not actually look like what he looked like in the shows. But in real life he had a really large eyeball on top of the star shape that he had as a body. You might think that the eyeball looks cute, but I thought that it looked completely disgusting. But Patrick was actually not a harm to humanity, because he was actually just a nice sea star and he would not want to hurt anyone, because he was just the same dumb old Patrick just like in the show. And SpongeBob, well, he did not really play a role in destroying humanity, so that is good for SpongeBob. Well, I don't know what just happened, because we just fell out of the world for some reason, because we wanted to spawn some more animals that were also there when the world was destroyed in a couple of years. But wait, do you remember what I said about Nicolas Cage? That was now Nicolas Cage. Well, do not forget to Google Nicolas Cage, because it is going to give you some giggles, mate. I am not sure of many things, but I know that when you are having a bad day and you have a computer to your access, you can just type in Nicolas Cage and you will have some giggles. So just thank me later when you are having a bad day and you type that in on Google, and it is going to cheer your day up. Let me know when that happens in the comments, because I want to know when that happens and if it happens, because it works for me. So, I thought that it might just work as well for you guys. But anyways, where were we on the whole story about destroying humanity and all kinds of stuff? I don't know anymore. I think I was somewhere on the Patrick line of story. So, I'll continue from there. I was a bit distracted by Nicolas Cage, but that happens to everyone once in a while, so that is nothing new. But anyways, we were at Patrick, and Patrick was actually a cute little thing that did no harm to humanity. What comes next? Oh, that is right, how could I forget? Well, have you guys at home seen that one episode where SpongeBob is trying to become better friends with Sandy the squirrel that comes out of Texas and likes to ride horses, and she likes to ride other things like worms and stuff? Well, I think you are going to remember that one episode in just a minute, because that one thing played a role in trying to destroy humanity as well. But anyways, there was a worm under the ground in Bikini Bottom where SpongeBob and his friends live, but that worm was not like any other worms, but it was a very large worm with sharp teeth in wrong places, and it could could swallow you. But as humanity was losing faith and winning this battle against the technology and all kinds of new creatures that now were also playing a role in trying to defeat humanity and stuff, there was this worm. Well, this day is not in the future from that year that all of that happened, but anyways, it is still in the ground. Don't try to ruin the story, please. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed today's video, but I have to go. Bye.